Hey guys, it's Brian from Toofab here. Today we are talking with Naomi Grossman from American Horror Story. You may not recognize her, but she plays Pepper on the show. Thank you so much for coming here today.
Thank you for having me here today.
Now, first things first, obviously we need to talk about how you look today.
Oh.
Because it's very different Pepper we see on television.
Yeah, I left my prosthetic gloves at home.
Now, from start to finish, how long does it take for you to get all the prosthetics on?
It's about a 3-hour process.
Was it like that from the beginning?
No, actually.
That's shorter.
Oh yeah, that's lightning speed compared to what it was. It used to be about, 6 hours with two guys. Now it's 3 hours with one. Yeah, it's pretty simple. Not simple, what am I saying? Because I don't have to do it.
Simple for you.
Right? Show up, sit back, take a nap. Wake up 3 hours later, you're Pepper. They have like a prosthetic nose, brow, ears. They of course have the fake teeth and a wonky eye. They shave my head every day. This is like 10 days old now. And of course, lob that little knot on my top. There's a fat suit and some prosthetic gloves. They don't miss anything.
Yeah. Now, do you get recognized a lot?
Lately, yes.
Yeah.
For Asylum, not as much, but yeah, anymore.
Now people know who you are as you.
It's true, yeah.
It's gotta start feeling kinda nice.
Right, I mean, in New Orleans, it was, they had their freak dar, finely tuned. So, and besides, if I, hang out with these guys, forget about it.
Now you mentioned hanging out with everyone in New Orleans and the people just in New Orleans having their how did you put it? Freak dar out?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What is it like there, and what are the fans, the local fans?
Well, in New Orleans especially, people are so nice. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you ask for directions, they will literally, take you there in their car. And then, take you to their family home for dinner after, and then add you to their will. They're just absurdly lovely there. It's always weird, just the reaction, because these are my friends. These are the people I hang with every day. And yet when we would go out into public, the reaction that people gave them, for the most part, it was always nothing but lovely. Yeah. Oh my God. You're on the freeze, I love you guys. Which was great. But, I remember being in an airport with Rose Siggins, and it was the people's reaction to seeing a person, walk on her hands. Mm. It kind of made me mad. I was seriously? Get a grip. Just move ahead.
Yeah.
Take off your shoes and take off your jacket and put it in the bin and be done. Mm-hmm. That's just me getting kind of defensive because
I think
they're my people.
That speaks to the show too. I mean,
yeah.
A big thing for this season is, just because you may look different, you're not really.
Right.
At the end of the day.
No, I mean, we all look different. You look different from me, and I look different from you.
So for you, obviously, this was a big deal this season that we had a returning character.
Mm.
Not just a returning actor or actress, because they do that every season, but
right.
You were Pepper again.
Yay!
How awesome did that feel, just to know that they wanted to bring your character in specific back?
Right. It's still kind of dawning on me. And I've been living it for the last 5 months. It's thrilling. But I thought, I was confused. I mean, what breaking their own rules for me? It just didn't seem possible, but apparently it is.
This week, Wednesday night's episode, Lily is returning as well.
Mm-hmm.
What are you allowed to tease us with for this week?
Well, I think I can just reiterate what's been said already, and that is that Freak Show contains Pepper's origin story. Mm-hmm. And so haven't seen that yet. Mm-hmm. And so we'll see that.
And for you, what was it like working with Lily again?
Oh, it was awesome.
Just nice to have her back.
Yeah, well, and especially because there's sometimes a hierarchy in Hollywood. Mm-hmm. There's the, series regular, and then the guest star.
Yeah.
And then the co-star, and then, she was a series regular, and I was a guest star. And especially in Asylum, it seemed like I was kind of came out of nowhere guest star. Maybe I shouldn't even be a guest star. And she never did anything to make me feel, less, but still, that exists.
Yeah.
This time around, you know, I'm still just a guest star, but she wouldn't be there if it weren't for me. And I think she knew that. And so she definitely, you know, she was very gracious and, you know, treated me with the greatest respect, as she should.
That's what we like to hear.
Yeah, no, but it's really lovely.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for coming here today.
Of course.
I can't wait to see how this story unfolds this week.
Yay, thanks.